So it's 2020 and you need to launch a product on Amazon and you're considering using a launch service. Well, stop, don't do it. Watch this video first, because in the video, I'm gonna explain to you exactly why launch services don't work anymore and they're not worth the risk. And if you stick around to the very end, I'm gonna show you guys my exact launch strategy for 2020 that's within Amazon's terms of service and completely safe, and also how you can build a customer list using this method. Okay, I'm not gonna lie to you. Launching and ranking products used to be so much easier than it is today, because really, as Amazon is a shifting, changing giant, the game has changed so much. And if we really want to stay competitive as sellers and be able to launch products effectively, we need to change our strategy to really fit Amazon's changing system. So when I started, things used to be so much easier. You used to be able to just sign up to a launch service, pay the $100 or $200, and pretty effectively launch a product to the first page for a number of keywords fairly easily. But the truth is, that's just not the case anymore. You can still use launch services, but really, honestly, my recommendation is that you launch with a PPC only launch. So what are launch services and what are the problems with them and what's changed, which means that really they shouldn't be used anymore? So effectively, the way a launch service works is that you pay a third-party company between $100 and $200, and they will then suggest to you, depending on the product type, what kind of percentage discount they think that you should offer to their audience. They will then take your product, offer it to the audience that they have, which will be tens of thousands of people, and say, do you want to buy this product at a massive discount? The audience that they have tends to be kind of discount hunters, people are always looking for a bargain. So it doesn't really matter what product it is, that audience will then buy that product at that discounted price. What happens for you is you get a surge of sales. And as most people know, really one of the biggest ranking metrics is sales velocity. So the idea would be that that increase, that drive of sales, would drive your product listing up for a number of key words. And the truth is, it did really used to work, but there were always a couple of problems with launch services, which is nothing new, and in my opinion, have just always been problems with launch services. And the first issue is that actually they end up being quite expensive. So yes, yeah, it's only $100 or $200 to pay to use the service, but you've got to take into account the discount you need to offer this audience. So let's say you do some research on a tool like Helium 10 or Jungle Scout, and they spit out a number that you should be giving away over an 8-day launch period. And let's say that's around 100 units. Now, if you're giving around a 90% discount on that product over 100 units, that can be a massive, massive cost for you. You know, if you're selling a product at around 15, 20 pounds and you're giving a 90% discount, you could be potentially losing up to about or 10 pounds plus per unit when taking into consideration the product cost and the Amazon fees you're gonna have to pay on that sale. So really the costs do start adding up massively. So that's one issue that I think has always been around with launch services. And the second issue is that you don't own that customer. So effectively, the launch service own that customer. That's the launch service's customer. That customer, their customer will then buy your product, but you don't have that customer's email address or any way of contacting them. And that's always been one of the problems. You wanna try and build a customer list when you launch, and launch services never offered that, and that's always been a problem. Now the truth is, launch services used to work. So those two issues didn't really bother me. I was happy to spend the money and I was happy not to have the customer list if my product ranked on the first page for number of keywords. Now, the big issue is that there's two big changes that mean that launch services are not really worthwhile anymore. And those are changes on Amazon's side, and those are very recent changes. So the first of those changes, which I am sure you have all heard of because it has just been going around everywhere, is listing and account suspensions. If you think about it, what Amazon really want to do is make as much money as possible and also try and keep things as fair as possible to try and keep as much negative media attention as they can get. really what you're doing with a launch service is two things that Amazon really don't like. Number one, instead of using their own advertising campaign, you're paying a launch service to basically manipulate the ranking. So not only are you doing something that's slightly dodgy and Amazon sees rank manipulation, which they don't really want press for, the second thing is you're basically taking money away from them, money that could be spent on that advertising campaign. So they do not like that. So recently, Amazon have been cracking down by removing listings and suspending people's accounts. And this is real, and this actually has been happening. So it's just not worth the risk to use a launch service anymore when you can do things in a completely different way and buy the books. And if you think about it, it's actually really easy for Amazon to know who is using these launch services because it's just not natural behavior. When someone buys something on Amazon, they go through a path on the website which Amazon tracks. So a normal customer who buys your product will go onto the Amazon website, they'll type something in, they'll search for it, they'll make look at a few products, and then they'll purchase. If you imagine with a launch service, what's actually happening is that person is either going direct to your product page with a direct URL, or they're potentially using a super URL, like a two-step brand or a two-step storefront URL, and Amazon can see that URL. So number one, that just looks suspicious. Secondly, you're gonna have a massive surge in sales, which for a new product is another suspicion. And then finally, the groups of customers that are purchasing your product have been flagged by Amazon as customers who are buying continuously at a discount, and really you don't want your account associated with those kind of customers. So all in all, it's really easy for Amazon to know who's using these launch services and pick flag you, potentially remove your product listing or suspend your account. Now, finally, the second change on Amazon, and this is debatable, but I really do believe this is true, is that Amazon have reduced the value of a discounted sale in terms of ranking. So if a customer buys a product at 100% of the sale price, or a product customer buys it at 50%, that 50% sale will contribute less to ranking than that 100% sale. Okay, so hopefully by now I've managed to convince you that using a launch service in 2020 is no longer a good idea. If that's the case, then what is the best launch strategy for 2020? But before I get onto that, if this is the kind of content you like and you're enjoying this video, guys, subscribe to the channel, turn the notifications on. Also, go check out my new Instagram page. So before I get on to the best launch strategy for 2020, it's really important to know that the most important thing before you launch is to make sure that your product listing is amazing. You need to have great pictures and a great copy, because it doesn't matter how good your launch strategy is. If you have a crap product listing, you're just not gonna get people converting once the eyeballs are on the page. So that is the first step that you need to make sure is done before you look at any of these launch strategies. So when it comes to actual launch strategies, I think you really have two options. Now, the first is a PPC only launch strategy, which I mentioned earlier. And guys, I'm gonna be doing videos on both these launch strategies in the coming weeks. So their links to those will be in the description and also somewhere here and here once they're available. So like I said, the first is a PPC only launch strategy. And if you don't know what PPC is, basically Amazon PPC is Amazon's advertising platform on their website. If you ever search for a product, the top few, maybe three or four, depending on what country you're in, products say sponsored listing. And effectively what you're doing is you're paying Amazon per person that clicks to show your product at the top of the search results, mimicking a organic ranking of number one, two, three, or four. Effectively, you're gonna get a lot more clicks and a lot more conversions for people who think that those are basically organically ranked products. Now, the second launch strategy that you can use, which if you need to be a little bit more competitive is probably not a bad idea, is a PPC launch strategy in combination with a Facebook ad and Facebook Messenger bot launch strategy. I've used this combined strategy many times for products that are a lot more competitive, and it really gives it that kind of extra drive that you need. And the cool thing about this second launch strategy is that you also can build a customer list that you can then remarket to or launch secondary products in the same brand to. So like I said, there will be videos to both of these launch strategies here and here or somewhere around here and links in the description. I really hope you found this video interesting, and as always guys, it's competition time. So every week I give a random viewer £10 via PayPal. All you need to do to enter the competition is subscribe to the channel, hit the like button and comment Amazon FBA in the comment section. If you want to ask me a question, feel free to comment that as well. I get back to every single person that leaves a comment. So thanks guys, and I'll see you in the next one.